Racing and away Sweetly was the race favourite in Great Nic. It's in front for a Mid of Mary. Riker on the outside, Unusual Art and Rosera. Next one there is Dwarf. Alatrioli's on the outside. Very wide, second last, furthest Dawn. Last of all is Bell Strider. It's in Great Nic, about 2.5 lengths in front from Riker. Third, the inside there is Mid of Mary. Fourth is Unusual Art on the outside of Rosera. A length and a quarter further back to Dwarf. A length and a half to Bell Strider. Alatrioli is second last on the outside, and first Dawn down the pit. Avenue, the side last of all, about 10 lengths off the leader. In Great Nic at the tab side, led by 3 lengths now from Riker. Third, Mid of Mary. Fourth, the outside is Unusual Art, followed there by Rosera. Next one, Dwarf and Bell Strider going forward. Second last is Latrioli. And first, Dawn swings and laughs, but In Great Nic at the 400 metres marker. Skipped away about 3 to 4 lengths in front here from Mid of Mary. Riker's on the outside. Next one there is Bell Strider, followed by Rosera and Unusual Art. But this one, In Great Nic, is well clear. It's about 5 lengths in front. Mid of Mary's up to the second. Riker the next one. Latrioli, Dwarf on the outside. But In Great Nic about 3 lengths in front with about 50 metres left to go. Mid of Mary tries on the outside. In Great Nic in front though. And In Great Nic has got home from Mid of Mary. Third, either Dwarf or Latrioli, followed by first Dawn Rosera. Next one, Riker, Unusual Art and Bell Strider. Dropped out to finish at the back of the fields. Oh, In Great Nic landing some good bets there.
Okay, very impressive. Plenty of speed, and Ronnie Stewart was quite happy to stay to the inside. We're sort of thinking that the rail's probably not the strongest place to be, but this horse, In Great Nic, was right up against those panels, showed plenty of speed. Although getting tied the last 50 metres, it was a good display and a good first-up performance trained by Rob Heathcote. So number 12, In Great Nic for Ron Stewart, takes out race 3 here at the Sunshine Coast over number 4, Mid of Mary, who chased hard all the way. Michael Carl was giving the leader a good start at the top of the straight, but probably got to within around about a half a length on the line. And I tell you what, the winner wouldn't have wanted much longer because the outside horse was gaining well. And third is close, right on the line, not much between Latrioli and Dwarf. In fact, it goes to number 6, Latrioli, third, and number 1, Dwarf, is fourth. So it's 12, 4, 6 and 1. 12, 4, 6 and 1. 113.29, a half a length by a length and a half. The last 600 metres in 35.14. So while left alone in front, In Great Nic certainly was able to get pretty soft sectionals in the early part of the race and come home in good time. Getting tired on the line, but doing what was needed to be done in scoring by a half a length. Okay, they're the details. Race 3 at the Sunshine Coast, well supported. In Great Nic takes out the third, paying around about the $2.80 right across the country. Mid of Mary second, Latrioli third. We're off to a break and then we're back to Wyon on the other side. Okay, joined by Mel Sharp. That was a great front-running display by In Great Nic.
Yeah, definitely. It was well-rated by Ronnie, and this is the horse that we've always thought we've had, but she's just been a bit slow to mature, and today she's put it all together, onwards and upwards.
Yeah, barrier trial was very good coming into this. You obviously had some confidence because there's good money there for her too.
Yeah, definitely. We've always had a healthy opinion of her, and like I said before, she's just been a bit immature and taking her time, but today she's put it all together, and I think there's more improvement to come.
All right, that's good to know, and great to see a host of owners here giving her a great reception as she comes back.
Yeah, they're a great bunch. That big shout out to Slade Bloodstock, who put them together, so really happy for them all.
That's what it's all about. Well done.
Thank you.
Thanks. Ron, that was a speed display by that filly.
Yeah, look, she's had a few little issues as a younger horse, and sort of I've been lucky enough to get on her a little bit later, and her trials have been really good. I think she'll be better with a bit of cover, but when she jumped that good in the grade she's in, I thought she'd be too good. Look, I just didn't want to overfight her because she has a tendency to, when she was younger, to run off a bit. Just got lost in front on the big straight and was a good win.
She was, looked like she was getting tired, but it may have been more the fact that there was just no one, or she didn't see the horses on the outside.
Yeah, exactly. I pulled her off about three off the fence, just in case, because she can run around a little bit. I wanted to get off the rail, but just that last bit, she started to really look for other runners and just got a bit lost in the big straight and sort of lugged back to the fence.
She'll win more?
I think so. She's a nice horse. Plenty of improvement. I think she'll improve when we take the sit as well.
Well done, Ron.
Thank you.
You can hear happiness staggering on down the street. Footprints dressed in red, and the wind whispers fairy. A broom is drearily sweeping up the broken pieces of yesterday's life. Somewhere a queen is weeping. Somewhere a king has no wife.